we can hear the gunfire just right behind me at the southern Lebanese border, and I'll just try to focus the camera on what's happening down there. There was a group of young people, Palestinians and Lebanese, coming close to the fence that marks the border of Lebanon. And as they came close, we started hearing gunfire. Now, in the beginning, the Lebanese army was firing to disperse the protesters and prevent them from coming close. But then later, as we hear from the sources here in Lebanon, they tell us that the Israeli army fired at the protesters. We're not sure yet who started the firing. And we can hear the gunshots now as we are speaking, Maktabi. And we're talking about a very close distance. This is probably a kilometer or even less far from where we are. When this all happened, the protesters came back and the organizers canceled the event, ambulances all over, and the army heavily deployed over here along with Hezbollah members for sure.
And this explosion of gunfire that we're hearing there, Rima, as it goes on this border, who is left there? I know that last time I talked with you a couple of hours ago, there were people everywhere. It looks like, thankfully, you're the only one there and you're in a safe place far enough from it. But who's around there? Who could they still be shooting at?
Well, Natalie, just 20 minutes ago, there were still young people close to the fence. The Lebanese army deployed right on the fence and tried to push the protesters back. So on the one hand, we think that it's the Lebanese army firing in the air, trying to scare the protesters and push them back. However, right now, as you hear the gunfire in the background, we're not sure if it's the Lebanese army engaging with the Israeli army. We cannot tell from this point or this location. However, we definitely know and see that the protesters have been pushed back.